As the year draws to a close, time to look at the best and the worst movies of 2017. So for that, we're joined by film critic and host of Pop Life, Richard Crouse, is here. Hard to go through. We were just talking about off camera. There's a lot of movies to go through for this list.
There's a lot of movies. And you know what? This year, the list that's at ctvnews.ca is a lot longer. We're just going to give you a little taste of it here.
Okay.
But there's more good movies than bad movies.
That's
and I think that might be the first year ever on these lists.
So let's talk about some of the bad. Sure. Let's begin with The Florida Project.
I love this movie. This is hands down one of the best films of the year. This is the story of a young single mom living in poverty in a motel just outside of Orlando, Florida, Disney World. And she has a young daughter. And this is a movie about how that young daughter lives her life. And the only person in it that you've ever heard of is Willem Dafoe.
Yeah.
Everyone else is brand spanking new. And this movie will make you cry. It will make you laugh. It will make you think. It is a story that could have fallen into cliche really easily and doesn't. Hands down,
one of the year's
best. Yeah.
And where do we see it now?
You probably on Netflix now. But although award season coming up, I imagine
might
this will be re-released a little bit.
Yeah. Okay, so Get Out.
Get Out is one of the weirdest and most original mainstream films to come along since The Babadook, a horror film. This is a movie that is social satire, it's horror, it's comedy. It's Jordan Peele, who we know primarily as a comedian from Key and Peele, stepping behind the camera and making one of the very best movies of the year.
Okay, so this is good. I like that. Mm-hmm. It's a nice reminder, too,
yeah.
because they come out, and if you didn't get in...
This came out in February, and so, you know, a lot of people... The old age wisdom would have been, oh, it came out in February, it's not going to get nominated for anything because Academy voters have short memories. They're remembering Get Out.
Okay, and Lady Bird, you thought, was a standout.
Fantastic. Mm. Lady Bird is Greta Gerwig. She is an actor that we know from Miss America and Frances Ha and loads of other stuff. And this is her behind the camera telling the story of growing up in Sacramento, California. Great movie, good script, the whole thing. Two towering performances. Laurie Metcalf as the mother and Saoirse Ronan, who I like to call Little Meryl, as the daughter. Fantastic stuff.
Excellent. Okay, Shape of Water.
Shape of Water, my very favorite movie of the year.
Really?
This is Guillermo del Toro telling a story that is part Beauty and the Beast, part, Creature from the Black Lagoon, something like that. Bang those together, and it is a romance, a thriller. It's a Cold War story. It's all that and more. It's exactly the kind of movie that made me fall in love with movies in the first place.
This is good. I like this. Still, a lot of people have holidays still, so it's nice to look for the best.
Go see the Shape of Water. It's fantastic.
Shape of Water, and now to the worst.
The flip side of the coin.
50 Shades of Darker.
Yeah, my slogan is I watch bad movies so you don't have to. And this is where this comes in. So 50 Shades Darker is, of course, the sequel to 50 Shades of Grey. This is a movie that, at one point, the main character, Anna Steele, played by Dakota Johnson, says, it's all wrong. All of this is wrong. And I say, truer words have never been spoken on camera.
There's the
this
line.
Year.
Yeah. But it did well at the box office.
Yeah, it did well. And there's a third one coming out, which will probably also do well.
Okay, The Mountain Between Us.
Okay, so how can you go wrong with Idris Elba, Kate Winslet, alone together on screen, save for a dog. It's a survival movie. Their plane has crashed. They have to stay alive. It's about heroics. It's about beautiful scenery in Western Alberta where the movie was shot. And midway through this movie, I was just hoping that the dog would eat both of them to stay alive and that this movie would end. It just doesn't work at all. And with those two performers in the middle of this thing, it should have been so much better.
We got about 30 seconds for Valerian and the City of a Thousand Planets.
Okay, so this is not only the longest title of the year, probably one of, but it's the most retina-frying movie of the year. This is a movie that if you imagined all the big science fiction movies of the last 60 years and then let them sort of put them in a shaker and shook them all up and threw it at the screen, this is what you'd get.
Worst movies of 2017 and also the best. Ed Richard, thank you very much for
Thanks
this.
So
Happy
much.
New Year.